Welcome back to our Proactive London studio, where I'm joined for the very first time by Ollie Green and Theo Green, who are the Executive Chairman and Chief Growth Officer, respectively, at Brave Bison. And I'm going to start with a question for you, Ollie. Perhaps you can tell us what Brave Bison actually is.
Hi, Tom. Brave Bison is a social and digital media company. There are effectively two parts to our business. The first part is where we own and operate a portfolio of digital channels across social media platforms like YouTube, Snapchat, TikTok, and Facebook. And we produce content, we license content, we push it out across our channels, and that content generates us advertising revenue. Some of our channels are actually owned by us, so we'll license the IP, we'll license the content directly, and we manage the channel end to end. And some of the channels are actually owned by a combination of rights holders, media companies, and also creators. We are now working with more and more. The second half of our business is a suite of advertising and technology services. So we work with typically global enterprise clients, companies like New Balance, Panasonic, Isuzu, and Currys, to ultimately help them grow and thrive in a digital world.
Thanks, Ollie. And it is indeed a very modern kind of a business, isn't it?
It absolutely is. We take a very modern approach to delivering work. Our teams are distributed across various different parts of the UK, Europe, and we also have a hub in New York City, which we're really excited about. And we also work at the cutting edge of digital, very close with the likes of Meta, YouTube, and Google.
Lovely stuff, Ollie. Thank you very much. Turning to you now, Theo, you're the Chief Growth Officer. You've got your finger on the pulse of how the business has been performing, and you had some results out back in April. How have things been going?
So things have been going quite well recently. Revenues have increased quite substantially. In 2022, they grew by almost 50% to over £30 million. And profitability has also increased substantially. We recorded an adjusted EBITDA of £3 million in 2022.
All right then, Theo. So obviously you and Ollie own 19% of this company between you. Just how satisfied are you with the way that it's been performing over the last couple of years?
We think things are going well. What keeps up us at night is more the opportunities and the things that we haven't yet achieved. Brave Bison is active in some very exciting markets that are continuing to grow, and we're keen to be at the forefront of that.
Great. And a beautiful segue, Theo, for my question for you, Ollie. Let's hear a bit about the vision for the future of the business, because as it's currently constituted, there are lots of moving parts. It's not always clear from the outside to see the direction that it's moving in, apart from generally upwards. So what would you like to achieve here?
Well, I think that we operate in some very exciting spaces. We're playing more and more in the fields of social media, which is clearly a growing market. We're very pleased with our Brave Bison Commerce business unit, which is where we work with enterprise retailers to transform their digital experiences online. And then we also have a very exciting performance business, a digital marketing business that helps companies plan and buy media across platforms like Meta, Google, and more retail media, actually. And so I think that each of those business units will continue to thrive, but we're more and more interested in how we connect the dots between the business units and actually go to market as an integrated business.
And Theo, you recently acquired a business called Social Chain that is now in the process of being integrated. So what's going on there?
Absolutely. So that's going well to date. We're very happy with that. Social Chain is a very exciting business. It's one of the leaders in social media advertising. So it creates content and it works with influencers to produce content for brands' platforms. And this is an area that's growing very quickly. It's an area with a lot of brand interest. And that's reflected in quite an exciting catalogue of clients that we now have, including KFC, including Apple, including General Mills. So some really big global brands.
I do just have one final question, which I'd like to put to the two of you, and it's one that I like to ask people the first time that I speak with them. Is there something that comes up when you're talking to potential investors or even existing investors that gives you the impression that people tend to misunderstand something about your business that you'd like to take this chance to clarify?
Yeah, I think obviously Brave Bison has been a listed company for some time. Ollie and I first invested into the business in 2019. We acquired a large stake in the market, but we've actually only been executives in the business since 2020. So we like to remind all prospective investors that the current journey and the current business plan is really only 3 years old. We feel we're just getting started. And Brave Bison is a fantastic platform from which to do that.
Thank you, Theo. And thank you, Ollie, as well. And thank you both very much for coming to talk to us at Proactive today. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you, Tom.
Thank you, Tom.